One thing we've learned in our work is that human beings have a tendency to see patterns, make inferences and judgments, and draw conclusions quite quickly from just a little bit of data. This is an important skill. It allows us to make thoughtful inferences and predictions, but it can also lead to bad or misinformed judgments when we're too quick to draw inferences from a small amount of data. In our work with schools, we have found that a mental model called the Ladder of Inference is especially useful in helping educators resist this tendency and stay focused on the evidence. The Ladder of Inference was first developed by business theorist Chris Argyris and popularized by Peter Senge and colleagues in a book called The Fifth Discipline, The Art and Practice of the Learning Organization. The Ladder of Inference is a metaphor organized around how we as humans tend to make patterns about what we see in the world. Whenever I perceive something, I first select some data to focus on. Then I add some interpretation, draw conclusions, and finally take actions. The actions I take then influence what kind of data I collect next. And for that reason, it can be very dangerous to go up the ladder too quickly. At DataWise, we like to use this model to help each other maintain a relentless focus on evidence. When we hear somebody add interpretations or draw conclusions too quickly, we try to use phrases like, "That statement is pretty high up on the ladder. What evidence are you using?" Or, "We're all making a lot of interpretations here. Let's try to go back down that ladder and talk first about the evidence."
That might be a good instructional suggestion, but let's stick with maybe what we wonder about what the student was thinking.
I jumped up on the ladder.
For example, imagine an administrator pops into a classroom and notices that there's lots of students chatting at once, but the teacher is over in the corner paying attention to just one student. If the administrator adds the interpretation that the student is distracting the teacher from his work and that the other children are taking advantage of the situation and just fooling around, the administrator might draw the conclusion that the teacher has classroom management problems and then put a negative note in the teacher's file. In that example, the administrator jumped from her observation that multiple students were talking at once and that the teacher was only talking to one student, both of which were true facts, but she interpreted that the teacher was distracted and that the students were off task, not taking the time to investigate whether other interpretations could have been equally plausible. For example, maybe the teacher was deliberately giving one-on-one feedback to each student that day, and the rest of the students were supposed to be engaged in small group discussions. By using the ladder of inference to help you note when you're making inferences, you can catch yourself every time you treat an interpretation as though it were a fact. Because this discipline can be so helpful, this course will give you lots of practice in starting low on the ladder and making a conscious choice whenever you want to climb up it. For each step of the DataWise course, you'll have a chance to look at an artifact from a school and make observations that are grounded in the data. A very helpful way of sticking to evidence that DataWise schools use is a protocol called I Notice, I Wonder. First, we focus on statements about what we notice. These statements should be as specific and non-judgmental as possible. Then, we wonder about what we noticed. These wonderings start to climb up the ladder to include interpretations of the data, but they're framed as questions since we are less certain of them. Wonderings allow us to ask meaningful questions about the evidence, while also providing a space to let us acknowledge the inferences that our minds may be jumping to. You will then have a chance to see how members of the DataWise team collaboratively notice and wonder when making sense of a wide range of data sources. This exercise will help you cultivate the E of the ACE Habits of Mind, a relentless focus on evidence.